BSMD joint programs offer exceptional high school students the opportunity to secure a spot in medical school even before they begin their undergraduate studies. If you're 100% sure that you want to pursue medicine at such a young age, this might be the right program choice for you. So today I want to talk about the pros and cons of choosing BSMD programs, and I'll give you a list of all the BSMD programs available in the US with their acceptance rate. At the end of this video, I'll tell you the five easiest BSMD programs to get into so you can maximize your chances of acceptance. Hi, I'm Nadine Evans with BeMo Academic Consulting. Make sure you subscribe on whatever social media channel you're watching this from now so you don't miss any of our upcoming videos. If you'd like us to help you get into medical school, click on the link either above or below this video to schedule your free initial consultation. Students pursuing the BSMD program stream will be able to obtain either a Bachelor of Science or a Bachelor of Arts, and will then be able to proceed directly into medical school to obtain a Doctor of Medicine degree. Medical schools will essentially reserve a place in medical school for these students, which makes competition into these programs very high and the available positions very low. Depending on the school, both degrees are completed at the same school, while in other cases, the bachelor's degree and the MD degree are completed at two different but partnered schools. Most programs are 8 years in length, but there are fast-track versions of these programs, which allow students to complete both their bachelor's and MD degree in 6 to 7 years. So how do you know if this program is right for you? Well, the pros of the program are obvious. You would have a guaranteed spot in medical school early on, meaning that you would skip the expensive, time-consuming process of applying to medical schools the traditional way. While many students will be stressing over applying to multiple schools, writing personal statements, completing secondary applications, taking the CASPER test, and writing the MCAT, as a BSMD student, you'd skip most of that hassle. In some cases, you might actually be able to skip the MCAT altogether, as some of these programs allow for this bypass. I should clarify that this guaranteed spot is only held if you maintain your grades and test scores throughout your studies. So you can't just get accepted and not do any work and still hope to get into medical school. You still have to work hard, but you're just streamlining the process, allowing you to devote any extra time into your studies. The other benefit is that in some cases you can fast track your bachelor's degree, completing it in just 3 years instead of four. So overall, this means that you can save an entire year of tuition and other fees and get into the practice of medicine sooner. A lot of these programs offer very good scholarship or grant opportunities for students. Some pay for the entire undergraduate degree, and a few of them even cover your tuition once you're in medical school. BSMD programs are generally small, admitting on average anywhere between 5 to 60 students. This allows for intimate connections with professors, mentors, and other students. Plus, if you're in a program where your BS and MD are both completed at the same school, it allows you to build strong ties in your community and provides you with both stability and familiarity. All good pros, but it's important to also consider the consequences of applying to BSMD programs. The biggest issue with these programs is that they require you to commit to a career as a medical doctor at only 17 or 18. This can stunt the opportunity for students to consider other fields, gain different experiences, and have the option of changing their mind. While it's true that you can drop out of these programs, it's definitely not a great option, and you may have already gone so far down the line that you're just left feeling lost and unsure of your future. These programs don't just require a commitment to the career. They also require a commitment to the school for up to 8 years. While other students have the opportunity to choose their medical school based on prestige, curriculum, scholarships available, match rates, etc., students in BSMD programs are stuck with the medical school that's linked to the program. Now, this doesn't have to be a bad thing, but it just eliminates other options that may have been better suited for you. Finally, the difficulty, competitiveness, and amount of coursework required for these programs is immense. Most BSMD programs receive hundreds, if not thousands, of applicants for their joint program, but many of them offer fewer than 20 available spots. The average acceptance rates for these programs is between 1 to 5%, but some extremely competitive schools have acceptance rates below 1%. These programs often set strict requirements in order for students to apply. So students usually have to be in the top 5 to 10% of their graduate class. They need to have excellent GPAs and must score extremely well on the SAT or ACT. Schools that are offering completion of both BS and MD degrees in 6 or 7 years do have the benefit of gaining time and saving money, but they also come with a cost: intense coursework, often requiring students to complete courses over the summer to finish on time. So with all this competition, how can you get into a BSMD program? First, you need to have a GPA as close to 4.0 as you can, ensuring that you'll be in the top 5 to 10% of your graduating class. Next, you need to score in the top percentile for the SAT or ACT. Now, even though grades and scores are weighted heavily, they're not the only factors the admissions committee are looking for. Most actually want a well-rounded individual that can demonstrate maturity, independence, and service to others. This can be demonstrated through the letters of recommendation that you'll need to gather and when you enter your extracurricular activities and volunteer participation. You can also expect to submit personal statements answering why you want to be a doctor and other supplementary essays. These all need to be very strong and unique to ensure that your application stands out. Make sure that you participate in extracurricular and volunteer experiences that can show your dedication and passion for medicine. For example, shadowing a doctor is extremely beneficial, first in your quest to determine if you truly want to become a doctor, and second, it will show the admissions committee that you're serious about pursuing medicine. Participation in research and tutoring are also great ways to prove your dedication to medicine. I want to note that not all of your experiences or activities have to be in the medical field. Whether you've played volleyball for years or have been part of the student council since you started high school, the important thing is that you demonstrate a deep commitment and interest in your activity. Use these experiences to reflect on what you've gained from them, what you've learned moving forward, and how the activity or experience will help you as you become a medical doctor. I've included a link in the description where you can find a full list of all the BSMD programs in the US. Under each school name, I've included the program acceptance rate, the number of available spots, the minimum required test scores, and the program length, so you'll have everything you need to get started and see how your scores match up. Now for the five easiest programs to get into. While we have information for many programs, not all programs are willing to provide their acceptance rates. Also, keep in mind that each year, these programs likely get more competitive as they receive more and more applicants, but the number of available positions stays the same. So currently, these are the five easiest programs to get into. At number five, we have St. Louis University School of Medicine. On average, they receive 1,000 applications to fill 90 available positions. This is one of the larger programs and they have a 9% acceptance rate. Number four is the University of Colorado School of Medicine's program. They receive roughly 100 applications for 10 available positions, giving them a 10% acceptance rate. Number three, the University of Minnesota Medical School. Each year they receive on average 50 applications to fill 10 positions into their BSMD program, so their acceptance rate is 20%. At number two, there's the Rutgers Robert Wood Johnson Medical School. In the previous year, they received 25 applications for their 6 available positions, making for a 24% acceptance rate. At number one, we have the Rutgers New Jersey Medical School. Last year, they received only 7 applicants for the 2 available spots, giving the program a 28% acceptance rate. Okay, so that's all I have for you. Hopefully you enjoyed watching, so please subscribe, like, and leave a comment if you have any questions. If you would like us to help you get into medical school, click on the link either above or below this video to schedule your free initial consultation. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.